The vacancy in the Vatican's highest seat is the latest challenge facing the Holy See as it struggles to gain a foothold and continue to be hounded by a scandal involving the supposed sexual abuse of minors by priests. What does the Pope's resignation mean for the Vatican? And what are the challenges facing his successor? We're joined in the studio by Father ARIS, SISON, Rector of the Immaculate Conception Cathedral of Cubao. Father, good morning.
Good morning.
Thanks for joining us, Father. This, I'm sure, came as a shock to you, as to everybody else. Mm-hmm. Maybe only a few, very, very few people knew of the Pope's plans, huh?
It seems that the cardinal themselves who were there, because the Holy Father announced this during a consistory, during a gathering of cardinals, they themselves were speechless. They had no idea that the Pope was going to say that.
Right. Can you imagine such a historic, hard decision, shocking everyone, including probably those even closest to him?
Yes,
I mean, I can't imagine what Pope Benedict was actually really thinking. Must have been, you know, when I think about it, between him and God, his decision to actually resign.
Well, he said very well that he has been praying about it. He has examined his conscience. And he said very clearly that he is making this decision with full freedom. I think he had to say that because the Holy Father is allowed to resign by canon law freely.
In a situation like this, Father, you told me that the last time this happened was back in 1514.
Yes.
I can't imagine what 1514 was. but that happened, I'd say, 607 years ago, more or less.
Yes.
This is the first time, because of mental and physical constraints, mm-hmm. that Pope Benedict decided to resign. That happens on February 28 at 8 p.m.
Yes.
Why is there even a time?
That means that at 8 o'clock in the evening on February 28, he is no longer in power. So there is a mechanism in the church for that. The Camerlengo takes over.
What's a Camerlengo?
The Camerlengo is, now it's Cardinal Bertone. He is the one who will be in charge of running the day-to-day affairs mm-hmm. of the church.
So
he is the one in charge of preparing and calling the next conclave that will elect the next pope.
This is also a cardinal.
Yes.
Cardinal Bertone.
Yes, he is now Secretary of State.
Does that mean he's the most senior among the cardinals?
The most senior, I think, is the dean of the cardinals. That is the former Secretary of State, Cardinal Sodano.
Okay.
But the Secretary of State right now is Cardinal Bertone.
All right. Does it follow that, Father SISON, that by February 28th, there must be already a new pope by then?
No, they have 20 days to convene a conclave and to elect a new pope.
So in 20 days, a new pope has to be elected already?
In 20 days, a conclave has to be convened.
In 20 days?
Yes.
It has to be convened. Yes. In other words, Father, from here, 20 days after, it's possible that that's only the time they will convene the conclave.
Yes.
And then when the conclave is convened, how long is it supposed to take them to elect a pope?
It depends. They can have up to 4 ballotings every day. And the cardinals need a 2/3 majority vote for somebody to be elected pope.
Wow. It's very madugo.
Yeah.
No? So it just goes on and on and on until they actually get the 2/3?
2/3 majority.
Or is there a process of elimination here?
Well,
I guess there has
to really
be.
Don't know, because they have to make a vow of secrecy. So I don't really know what happens inside. We can just imagine. There are, at the moment, 118.
Okay, 118. Okay.
At the moment.
And that includes our own Cardinal Tagle.
Yes.
Okay, 118. Yes. So are all these cardinals right now, Father, are probably in different parts of the world as well?
Yes.
Like Cardinal Tagle, I believe, he is here in the Philippines.
I could imagine that they're already scheduling a conclave.
Absolutely.
Probably they're preparing already how to do it. The Vatican spokesperson said that we will most probably have a new pope by Easter. That's March 31.
That's a long time. That's a month.
It is.
Right from the time the pope's resignation takes effect. Okay, so it doesn't seem like they're running out of time here, or racing against time, rather, if they're looking at a month. So how we understand it is this, Father Sison, they vote four times a day.
Mm-hmm. They can have four ballotings a day, and two in the morning, two in the afternoon.
And what, do they only vote for one? Or do we know?
I don't know. I don't know their process. I don't know if there are nominees.
Yeah.
I know they cannot campaign. I know they cannot vote for themselves. There have been movies about how a conclave is conducted, but I really don't know if it's factual. I don't know if happens that way.
Is it true, possibly, Father, that this is something we'll never know? Or are the cardinals open, or the spokesperson of the Vatican, are they open to actually telling us how the voting process takes place?
No.
They're not. We're not supposed to know. It's not open to media.
It's not open to...
Yeah, obviously, but I'm talking about the rules that govern the voting. Is that something transparent? Is that something open to the public? We just don't know.
Yes, yeah.
Or you can't share it with us because you're not very certain about it.
I know the general rules. I know about the two-thirds majority.
Okay. That they can't vote for themselves.
Yes, yeah. The cardinals are the first duty of the cardinals is to elect the pope. And they themselves are automatically candidates.
Yeah.
Although theoretically, it's not limited to them.
It's not?
It's not.
Oh, so a person can be a pope without being a cardinal?
Yes, theoretically, yes.
Has that happened in the past?
I am not exactly sure, but it is possible.
How? Because the cardinals can actually vote from somebody outside the conclave.
Yes. It is possible.
But most likely, Father Sison, it's going to be coming from...
Among them. Most probably among them.
Has history proven that in the past it would always be one of the more senior cardinals that get elected as pope?
It seems that, in a time like this, when a pope dies or when we're looking forward to a conclave, there are names that come up. These are what we call in Italian papabili, the candidates to be pope. The names they float don't come up.
Really? The names that float don't
get elected most of the time.
Okay, so some names have been floated.
Yes.
Already. Actually, even Cardinal Tagle.
Yes. Well, he is a candidate. His name has come up many times.
Because he has this charisma. They say that Pope John Paul II is similar, to Pope John Paul II. Can you imagine to actually... Well, of course, he's a candidate, but for him to his name to be even floated just brings so much pride to many of us.
Actually, Cardinal Tagle's name has already been coming out even before he became cardinal in December last year.
Why?
Well, he's known all over the world to be a really intelligent and good bishop.
Wonderful,
People have been asking me if it is possible, I say definitely.
All right. Let's look at the legacy. What kind of legacy do you think Pope Benedict the 16th will be leaving us, the Catholic Church?
Pope Benedict is known more than anything else as a theologian. He's a first-rate theologian. And he spent more than 20 years in the Vatican heading the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith. And if you look at his letters... His homilies, his teachings, it has always been about truth, about faith, about hanging on to the faith despite all odds.
But isn't that what every priest tells us?
Well, that seems to be a mark of this pope. Some criticize him for not being a very pastoral pope, but he is definitely a first-class teacher. First-class theologian.
Apart from that, what else can we remember him by? Of course, a lot of things have... he's against gay marriage, abortion.
Those are... Well, the church has been against those those things
but
for a long time.
Wasn't Pope Benedict very vocal about it among all the other popes?
I believe so, because it's during this time that those issues came up.
Mm-hmm. Remember, Father, there was a time that Pope Benedict also apologized for alleged, you know, sexual abuses,
yes,
by priests,
yes,
on children.
Yes.
But there's been talks or write-ups that he might have been sorry, he may have apologized, but he didn't do much about it. What can you say about that?
Well, that has been the accusation not only of the Pope and but also of the bishops, primarily in the United States. I really don't know what those accusing them want of the priests. I think we have to go through the process of, first of all, establishing guilt. And then, if they are found guilty, then they are punished. But I think that has to be done with a lot of prudence, and that everybody is innocent until proven guilty. So there are so many accusations left and right. But in fairness to them, those who have been proven guilty have been punished.
What is the punishment for priests who are found to have sexually abused children?
In the United States, a big number of them have been dismissed from the priesthood.
And jailed.
Yes, of course. Because
so just
they
like any normal, ordinary,
yes,
person.
Because we have liabilities as priests and as citizens of the state.
Yeah. I guess, you know, you're a priest and you're a citizen.
Yes.
So whatever penalty or repercussions a citizen would face, obviously you would face that too.
Of course.
Your profession or
yes,
your mandate,
mm-hmm,
as a priest of the Catholic Church. Looking at the cardinals, Father, is there anyone you think, personally, do you have a favorite among them, say for Archbishop Tagle?
Honestly, I don't know many of them.
Oh, you don't?
I don't. When I was a student in Rome, I knew many of them. I saw many of them. I met Benedict in the bus.
Really?
Yes. That's my only encounter with the present Pope.
Did you even think that he would be Pope?
I knew him because he was Pope. I was a student in Rome in 89 to 92, and I knew him as Cardinal Ratzinger. So I met him in the bus. I saw a priest in his garb, but I noticed it had red trimmings. So I said, this must be a cardinal. So I looked at him, and it was Cardinal Ratzinger. I remember I offered my seat to him, and he just smiled at me.
Did he take your seat?
No, he didn't.
But among those of the cardinals right now, I mean, among priests, do you guys talk about it? I mean, who possibly would be a good,
yes,
successor?
Yes.
Who's a possible?
Well,
good
of course,
successor?
The one I know is Cardinal Tagle, from Manila. I have been personally following Cardinal Dolan of New York.
Dolan?
Yes.
Okay.
Timothy Cardinal Dolan of the Archdiocese.
What's he like?
Funny, very intelligent, and very witty.
Hey, that's nice.
Yes, quite a good combination.
I don't think we've had, I haven't been, you know, alive too long, a witty Pope. But I don't know, even if you have a witty Pope, I can't imagine the Pope coming out with those witty lines.
Yes, I like him, and I've been reading his books, because he has a way of making the traditional teachings of the church relevant to people today.
Nice.
Yes, very, very nice.
Is it more so, Father, he makes it a little bit more practical?
And humorous.
See, that's, you know,
yes,
sorry, but sometimes we really need that,
yes,
because in a way it gets a little boring.
Yes, sometimes
and too,
it does.
By the book.
Yes.
You know, and mm-hmm, sometimes it's a little hard to apply it to your,
mm-hmm,
normal daily life. So that's Cardinal Dolan.
Mm-hmm.
Is he up in the running? I mean, of course, they all are, but matunog ba yung pangalan niya?
In the United States, yes.
Ah, really?
It seems he's their number one candidate.
But they remember they were saying, but of course, these are just reports because of the surprise announcement last night that maybe from Europe, the Pope might be coming from Latin America.
Well, that's, they seem to be floating that idea because...
But remember what you said, what they float never wins. Wasn't Pope Benedict's name floated during the death or after the death of Pope John Paul II?
I really don't know. I think they were also looking at... I remember when John Paul II died, they were saying that the Italians would get it back.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was limiting my list to the Italians, but it came out to be Cardinal Ratzinger.
All right. So now that this is done, I guess I forgot to ask you this. What does a move like that by Pope Benedict say about the kind of person he is, Father?
First of all, it showed me how honest he is and how humble he is. He says, the world today is so fast-paced. There are so many demands. And he said, I feel I'm too old to keep up. I am not able to fulfill my duties because I am no longer that young. I am no longer that strong. I think it takes a lot of courage and humility to step down.
Absolutely. I agree with you, Father. Father, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Of course, you can imagine how we will be covering the all the events that will lead to the election of the new Pope. Again, to those who may have joined us, Pope Benedict the 16th just announced his resignation last night. So you can imagine that members of the Catholic Church and the faithful have been surprised and shocked by this piece of news. We're looking at the meeting of the members of the conclave anytime soon, but Father Season is telling us that from here on they have 20 days to convene the conclave.
From 20 days from February 28th.
From February 28th to convene. So they actually might do it then. Actually, you know what a good sign would be?
Yes.
Once Cardinal Tagle leaves the Philippines.
I'm trying to find out. I'm not exactly sure if he's there in the consistory last night. But he might be there, let's see how things evolve starting on the evening of February 28th.
One last question. What do you think the challenges the new Pope will be facing?
Things are happening so fast in the church, in the world today, largely because of communication, because of the internet. There are so many demands, and I think there is need for quick action, quick decision on many, many things. I don't know. Some say they're looking forward to a young pope, but they say if we elect a very young pope, he might stay on for so long.
That's true. That's also the,
you know, the cardinals will really have to pray and discern what kind of a pope we need at this point in our lives.
Maybe not too young yet, not too old, somewhere in between. Because I can imagine, you're right, if you get a young a cardinal elected as pope, that cardinal / pope will be reigning for such a long period of time.
Okay, so what? I think the youngest cardinal now is 53. Cardinal Tagle is the second youngest cardinal.
How old is Cardinal Tagle?
I think he's 55.
Okay, that's not too young. Pinipilit. All right, Father Season, thank you again.
You're welcome.
Coming up,